based on my recent paper and this paper, this collaboration with Kitazawa-san and Kanemaru-san. But seeing in diagram, this talk is about physical space. What is the physical space? As we know, that the universe is a positive cosmological constant with given by the physical space, because it's nothing but the exponential expanded universe. And the important part, because physical space has a cosmological horizon, so following the deconstruction formula, that the state entropy is proportional to the area of the horizon, which is two quantities are important quantities in my talk. The important point is the cosmological constant is proportional to the square of Hartle parameter, and the entropy is anti-proportional to the h square. Then if the G2 quantity analytically scale with time with some mechanism, there may exist an unified understanding of G2 evolution. For example, there will be expected that the entropy increase with time. Such an entropy increase is nothing but the cosmological constant. That is one example of understanding of G2 evolution. Of course, the key question is what is the mechanism to give rise to such a kind of evolution? So let us consider the masses and minimally coupled scalar field. Minimally coupled means the absence of the Ritz scalar and the pi square term. Since the Ritz scalar is constant in the space, it behaves like mass term, so I mean the, including the absence of the Ritz scalar pi square term, we consider the masses. In such a Ritz scalar field case, such a Ritz scalar field includes the scale invariant spectrum, and this spectrum is dominant at the superhorizon scale. Then in evaluating the, such an invariant contribution, we set the upper bound on the horizon. On the other hand, since this propagator has infrared divergence, we fix the minimum value of the homomorphism. So in terms of the physical coordinate system, the upper bound, as I said, means the upper scale, size of the horizon, and since now we are considering the digital space, the upper scale is just constant, does not change with time. On the other hand, the lower one corresponds to the size of the universe, it expands by the scale. Since the upper scale is just constant with the cosmic evolution, and on the other hand, the size of the universe is expanding with the scale factor, then with the cosmic evolution, the parameter, the outside the horizon becomes wider and wider. The fact means that the momentum interval also becomes wider and wider. And this kind of increase of degree of freedom and the existence of the scale invariant spectra induces the logarithmic dependence of the scale factor in scalar. In the presence of the right scalar field, the physical quantity may acquire a time-dependent quantum effect through the propagator inside the loop. Note that, of course, we know that the propagator itself is not physical quantity, but we also know that the quantum correction consists of the propagator. Then the time-dependence of the, such a propagator may indicate the physical quantity may acquire a time-dependent quantum. Intermediate to the origin of energy scale, we call them the quantum. So how about mass field? If the field of mass is comparable to the Hubble parameter, such infrared electrons do not appear. So in such a case, the exponent of the denominator becomes smaller than 3, so there is no infrared divergence. I mean, this propagator is not sensitive to the increase of freedom. So in order to obtain the secular growing term and dependent quantum effect, we need to fine-tune the quadratic term of the scalar field. So in that sense, the scalar field is not an attractive candidate to introduce, to induce the quantum effect. but we have a more attractive candidate. Actually, the gravitational fluctuation of the Vegeta background also induces the quantum effect. In contrast to the scalar field, of course, the fine tuning of the polarity term is not necessary. So, with the fine tuning, gravitational fluctuation can induce the time dependent quantum effect. Concerning this fact, Zamis and Luder conjecture that the Vegeta space is unstable due to the self-gravitation. Note that the gravitational fluctuation of the Vegeta background can induce the time dependent. If such a gravitational infrared effect screens the Hubble parameter, that is nothing but the instability of the Vegeta background. That is the conjecture. So what we did? We derived the elective action up to the boundary level and found that the dimensionless coupling consists of the Newton's coupling and the Hubble parameter. That is the unique choice of the dimensionless coupling in Einstein gravity. It's dynamically screened by Sofia gravity. Then our result may give a positive answer to this conjecture. Furthermore, we found that the time evolution of the corresponding the entropy can be identified with the quantum entropy of the conformal theorem. So there is a time evolution law increase with time. Then in terms of the entropy, this screening of the Hubble parameter solution is favored. So let us let me explain our setting. We consider the Einstein Hilbert action with the parameter, and we parameterize the gravitational fluctuation like exponentially because we want to investigate the anomalous scaling dimension and the exponential parameterization is used. And furthermore, in order to fix the gauge, we introduce this gauge fixing term as an example. And the important point is the gravitation, some mode of gravitational propagator, for example, the H2 component. And the conformal mode or the Torres's special tensor and the special part of the FP growth behaves like a massless scalar field. Then in a similar way of the massless scalar field, this right mode can induce the secular growth time dependent quantum effect. Okay. On the other hand, actually there are some mode has a mass which is comparable to the Hubble parameter. This mass mode do not contribute to the time-dependent quantum effect, and then actually we do not need to consider such a mode. For example, the HZ-2-omega has a mass mode, then we can migrate. That is why we can identify the HZ-2-omega. And let us see the action at the one-loop. On a homogeneous isotropic background, at the one-loop effective action is written like this. The important point is the three term, the curvature term, and the cosmological constant term, and the new term, which is proportional to the traceless part of the rich tensor. This first two terms can be easily understood. These two contributions given by the anomalous scaling of the rich scalar and the cosmological constant. The third term is a little bit difficult because this term breaks the covariant. Temporarily, let us forget about the third term and check this first two term. By looking at the coefficients, the rich scalar term defines the scaling of the gravitational coupling and the cosmological constant term scaling define the scaling of the H square over kappa square. By considering this behavior, we can expect that the effective Hubble parameter decay with time. That is nothing but the renormalized scale factor is deformed from the Vegeta space. Note that the AC is the partial solution, then that is nothing but the Vegeta solution. And we expect that the renormalized scale factor is deformed by the anomalous. anomalous dimension related to the amplitude of the gravitational problem. However, actually, if the scale factor has an anomalous dimension, the third term does not disappear, then the non-covariance remains. That is the problem. So how to avoid this problem? Actually, by introducing the inflaton as a counter term, whose slow parameter is identified by the anomalous dimension. By introducing this inflaton, we can eliminate the non-covariance. And in the light of the covariance, we can naturally introduce the inflaton. That is the merit of our approach. And eliminating the non-covariance term, we can obtain the completed covariant effective action. And consider from this effective action, we can evaluate the decay of the decay of the dimensionless couple. So that is nothing but the instability of the space. So let us consider the corresponding to the Gibbons quantum formula. Of course, if the Gibbons quantum nature are identified by the denormalized coupling, it grows its time. But that, this image is quite tricky. So actually, there exists other approach to evaluate the entropy. Let us recall that the digital entropy can be derived by, that is nothing but the partition function, because in the digital space there is no internal energy. So by evaluating the partition function with the conformal zero-modal fluctuation, we can produce the time evolution of the digital entropy. Okay, and it increases this time. And note that we express the time evolution like entropy gamma, but of course, our investigation, as seen in this term, our investigation is just local. We just, it's not exact 8 to gamma, it's just 1 plus 2 gamma. Our investigation is just first order perturbation. In that sense, the time evolution is just local. So, of course, this investigation is not so useful because we are, for example, in order to investigate the physical implication of the inflation or the dark energy, we want to know the whole time evolution in the accelerating expansion. So how to obtain it? Actually, we can derive the time evolution of entropy by using the Von Neumann formula. So if the superhorizon dynamics can be described by the Hopper-Planck equation. We don't know the Hopper-Planck equation of gravity, but maybe up to the 100 levels, the distribution function of the conformal norm may be described by the Gaussians. And usually the Hopper-Planck equation has a drift term, but since we are considering the massless model, there is no drift. Then the solution of the Hopper-Planck equation, that is nothing but the distribution function of the conformal norm, is equal like that. So since by using this solution, we can construct the Von Neumann entropy by evaluating minus tau s log log log. That this is the result, and this result surely reproduces the local time evolution of the digital entropy. And that is just consistency check, but the most important point is the point we derive the global time evolution of the quantum in contrast to the digital entropy. So by considering, let us identify the, this global time, time evolution as the time evolution of the entropy. So the time evolution of the entropy is given like that. And let us recall that the entropy is nothing but the action partition function. Then in analogy of the normalization group flow equation, by imposing the time independence of the given, so time independence of the reaction, we can derive the beta function of the coupling. Of course, our investigation is just up to the one level, but by serving the, this one function exactly, we can obtain the global time evolution of the coupling. And the inverse of the coupling is just in order to obtain the covariance of the electric action, it is necessary to introduce a reflex inverter at the counter. In that sense, the inverter is naturally introduced. Note that in starting point, there is no inverter, but in order to obtain the covariance, the inverter should be introduced. That's the point. And the resulting electric action shows that the dimensionless coupling is screened by the nothing but the instability of the system. Furthermore, of course, the corresponding position entropy increases with the decay of the coupling. And this, even talking entropy and evolution can be identified with the polynomial entropy of the coupling. And in contrast to the Hamilton entropy, and the polynomial entropy can describe the global time. So from the two, in the entropy, we get the one-dimensional function, and solving it, we find the quite of non-perturbative time equation. Okay. This is something that I still have time, so I want to mention the physical implication of our result. So applying the global time evolution, we obtain, we predict, we make the prediction of inflation, inflation and dark energy. So we predict the value of the scalar spectrum index and the phase scalar ratio, and the, for that energy we predict the deformation from the cosmological constant. I don't have enough time to explain the detail, but the important point, these predictions are still consistent with the observation. So I mean all the predictions are related to the Arab region, but these are
usually we perform dynamical realization group to sum over the log to determine the long time cyclic effect. Do you do this thing?
This process, I think, corresponds to the solving the Gamma-Neumann margin. Yeah, it looks that the coordinate is given by time.
You mentioned before it was for small time, and this is the place you...
Yeah, global time.
Okay, thank you.